Bien.
Wow, that's brilliant. I love Florence Nightingale.
Okay, Robert, can you just tell us what you remember of what happened?
Yeah, I remember it very clearly. We were trundling along and there was a beam of light. We were approaching a bend and there was a beam of light that came along. And the very next thing, it was like split seconds later, this huge train was right in front of us. It was a mass of orange and red. And my thoughts were, we're going to be okay. It's all right. And it just kept coming. I thought, oh, maybe we're not going to be okay. But nobody panicked in the train at all. And the seats started buckling and the floor buckled up, and then people at the back got squashed, and I was just a little bit way behind Lawrence, and he went through the windscreen. But the spirit was amazing. Everybody was helping one another and trying to help each other out. We had to leave Lawrence and Ree back in there because they'd broken things, but everybody else was just cuts and bruises. I think I damaged my ribs on the side of the... I turned round. I must have hit the back of the chair. Poor old Peter was lying there, just really upset.
Yeah.
But we're thankful that nobody dead. It could... I mean, the train had been going just a little bit faster and we'd all been demolished completely. The Indian ladies were sitting at the side of the road praying for everyone, which is nice. Life goes on.
Support
that.
See you.
One. Hey, man, how are you?
I'm okay.
I'm glad. I was really worried about you.
I know. Thank you very much. You took care of me. You took good care of me. Thank you.
We live to fight another day, mate.
Well, this is part of the fight to save Peru.
That's right. We have to now fight even harder.
Right. I think we have a message here. Mm-hmm. I mean, we all have to be strong and violent. Not violent, but how do you say, courage.
You know, when people attempt and do good things, you always get the negative forces coming out.
Exactly.
You have to be stronger and beat them.
Yes. And fortunately, it's been nothing really serious. It's okay. But thank you very much. I know you took care of me as soon as I came out, and I didn't know you were in pain. Thank you.
I'm just thankful you're okay, Peter. How's Brandon?
He's okay.
1-5 now.
Cold tea, cold warm. What? Cold morning warm tea, yeah.
That was 160 on the end.
Perfect, everything. It is some accident.
It's just an
accident.
Well, I was just talking with Peter, and Peter was saying something, if you can say it, because...
Look, this is a human accident.
Absolutely.
but this whole trip was about a much bigger, terrible thing that's happening.
Yeah.
And
right.
The pain we're suffering here is nothing compared to the pain
right.
unless we do what we're doing.
Exactly.
And that's the message we have to get out, because sometimes the media will only listen.
Mm-hmm.
When humans have accidents, they can see.
That's true.
Exactly.
But there's another accident happening that they're not paying attention to, which we're trying to bring attention to. That's the whole purpose of the trip.
I think it's an excellent idea.
And this is what Pedro will talk to the media when we get there. So
yeah.
Hopefully the accident will help educate.
I mean, we are here with our courage. You had the courage to come to Peru. We are here with our, spirits high, and we believe in saving this country for its natural wealth, that the world needs it. My children need it. I'm doing it because, I can live an easy life. What about my children? I have three boys.
Mm-hmm.
Peter,
I want to live in Peru. I want my country to be safe and in peace and prosperous, but I don't want to lose all this wealth, this natural wealth that it's been keeping because of all this crisis, which is a mixed blessing, which is the same crisis you're having. It could be the micro situation is what's happening now. We have an accident, we overplay it,
mm-hmm.
and then we find out that that accident makes us realize that we should go ahead with something.
Well, you proved it to us. I mean, you had the courage to organize this.
That's
we all know what it means in this country. Come out of the silence and do things.
Yes, I mean, you're bound to any accidents in an adventure trip. We've made everything possible, and at the safest place is where we have the accident. So that is a blessing in itself, because if we had an accident any of the other parts of the trip.
Yes, nowhere to go.
Well, yes, we now have the Air Force doing a great job. The Air Force of Peru is
marvelous
people worried about our country.
People
have to help Peru and save Peru. They love their country. And this is also something very important.
The people here have made a lovely job for us.
Yes, all the people
here, they have worked, they have helped us. Incredible way.
With a lot of tenderness, like all the Peruvian people is.
Yeah.
5,000 fanatics came, blur that, I saw all the women coming and seeing us,
not as
something to see what you happened, but coming and saying, be okay.
Mm-hmm. Really. Giving blankets, giving medicines.
So that shows that we are a peaceful country, and we're just passing a bad moment. Like we are at the present moment.
That's 163 on the end.
the 165.
Six on the end.